Hello students, I am Pankaj Tiwari discussing second topic polynomials of class 10. We are discussing topic polynomials. So first of all, we will start from its definition. So what is the definition of polynomial? Actually, this topic we have also read in 9th standard. So, its definition is very clear to you. Still, I am reciting it. Any algebraic expression which is containing positive integer powers of x is known as polynomial. I am emphasizing on two specific words, positive integer powers. For example, if I am writing x square plus 2x plus 3. This expression is a polynomial because everywhere variable contains positive integer powers. But in this expression, if I write like this, then this expression will not be a polynomial because it contains negative power. Likewise, if I write like this, this expression will also not be polynomial because this expression is equivalent of this. It also contains negative power of x. Now, I am writing another interesting polynomial, x square plus 2x, 2 root x plus 2 equals to 0. Tell me whether this one is a polynomial or not. What do you think? Whether it is polynomial or not? So it is also not a polynomial. Look how. Because this is equivalent of x square plus 2x raised to power half. This means half power plus 2. It is not an integer power. Positive integer power. So it is also not a polynomial. Okay, now you can easily recognize what expressions are polynomial and what expressions are not polynomial. So this one is a very basic phenomenon. Now we move further. There is a term, degree of polynomial. Polynomial is recognized by its degree. So first of all, we must know what is the degree of polynomial. If I am writing a polynomial px equals to x cube plus 3x square plus 2, this polynomial has degree 3. Highest power of variable is known as its degree. Specifically, this polynomial is cubic polynomial. If I am writing like this, x plus 2, this is a linear polynomial because it contains one power. But in 10th standard, we are discussing polynomial, specifically quadratic polynomial, whose standard form is this one, ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. This one is the standard polynomial. Here, b may be 0, c may be 0, but a cannot be 0. If a will be 0, then it will become linear polynomial. So it is not a quadratic polynomial. So we are discussing here which polynomial? Quadratic polynomial. We are discussing specifically quadratic polynomial. Now, any polynomial, how many zeros it contain? Number of degree will decide how many zeros it will contain. Because we are discussing quadratic polynomial, so it will contain 2 degree. If it is a 2 zeros, zeros means solutions. One also word for it. Roots. You may say answers all are synonyms, specifically zeros and roots. These are two favorite words. So now we can recognize the degree of polynomial. We will see highest power of x involved in it, that will be polynomial of that, that will be degree of that polynomial. Now because we are discussing quadratic polynomial, so polynomial will be like this: ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. It will contain two zeros. How many zeros? Two zeros. Let alpha and beta are its two zeros. Now very important topic we are going to discuss. Please be careful. Now sum of zeros. Sum of zeros. It has two zeros. If we will do sum of those zeros, then it will be decided by formula minus b upon a. Product of zeros, this will be decided by formula c upon a. This will be decided by the formula c upon a. So please note this one. This one is very important. You should note it. I am waiting for 1 minute. You should note it. This one is very important. Okay. Now we take one question regarding this. I am taking question from your NCERT. X square minus 2x minus 8. This one is the question from exercise 2.2. Question number first part. 2.1 I will discuss after this topic. Now what you have to do? I will read the question. Find the zeros of the following quadratic polynomials and verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients. You have to do here 2-3 works. First you have to find its zeros, then verify its relation between coefficient and its zeros. So how can we solve it? See carefully. First of all, we will factorize it as we attempt in 9th class. Factors of 8, which will give you 2, you can tell easily, 4 into 2, x you will take common, inside bracket x minus 4, 2, what will be here, x minus 4, in both the places x minus 4 is here, x minus 4 and x plus 2. Now, actually 0 is understood here. You can apply it here or not. It is up to you. If product of two numbers is zero, then what condition arises here? Do number ka product kab zero ho sakta hai? Can you tell me? If both the numbers are zero, then product will be zero. If this one is zero, then also zero. Zero into four, zero. Four into zero, zero. Zero into zero, zero. So condition is this: either x minus 4 equals to 0, so you will obtain x equals to 4, 1 0 is this one, or x plus 2 equals to 0, you will obtain x equals to minus 2. So you will write 2 zeros, therefore 2 zeros are 4 and minus 2. 2 zeros are 4 and minus 2, clear? Now, we are going to verify the relationship between its coefficients and zeros. See how we will do. First of all, we will do it sum. Sum is 4 plus minus 2, it will give you 2. Now, product 4 into minus 2, it will give you minus 8. Now, we are going to verify. Verification. You must understand the meaning of verification. If I am going to verify something, well, I will ask it by two students. What is the, for example, I am asking your Hindi teacher, who reads you Hindi? You are telling me certain name. If I am not confirmed whether you are telling me properly or not, then I will confirm it with second student. If answer is same from here, then I will sure that this verification has done and your Hindi teacher is this one. Okay, so like this, we have already done sum and product. Now we are going to verify. So we will find sum by another method. Now see, what is the formula I have told earlier? For sum, formula is minus b upon a, and product, formula is c upon a. So first of all, here question arises, what are a, b and c? So let me clear you. What is a? Coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square is a, which is 1 here. A is 1. Coefficient of x with sign is known as b, which is minus 2. And constant term, whatever it is, it will be c. Now see here, minus b, in place of b you will put 2, a 1, you will get 2. Product, product c upon a, c is minus 8, a is 1, so it is minus 8. Now you can easily see, sum is 2 here also, sum is 2 here also. Product is minus 8 here, product is minus 8 here. Hence verify. Now question has been completed. On the basis of this, you can find the answer of its another part. It will be homework for you. Later I will tell you in second topic. 3x square minus x minus 4. It will be homework. It is your homework. In next topic I will take you further from it. Okay, thank you.